Libra, welcome to your summarized version of your 2020 annual reading, and thank you for joining me here. I greatly appreciate it. I gotta say, before I really dive deep into this, that I gotta remind you, it's a general reading, so not everything here is going to resonate, okay? You have to take what applies, discard what doesn't. Of course, you know, I offer private I've not even said that to other people. I offer private 12-month forecasts for, you know, relationships and finance. And so that would be something where I would get specific into your natal chart, okay? And it would be a reading just for you, but a reading that's going out to thousands of people, you know, you got to take what applies and discard what doesn't. Most of you guys know that, so sorry you had to listen to it, but the other thing I've got to mention is that I know, you know, when we do the annual readings, a lot of people like to hear that it's their year and they're going to own it. And you know what? It is. It's going to be your year. You're going to own it. But guess what? So is everybody else. So let's stay grounded. Let's be with reality. Don't shoot the messenger, because I got to keep it real. And if you are somebody who just wants to tell you that, you know, you're going to hit the lottery next year and Don Juan's going to come riding in on a white horse, I mean, I know this is sexy to most people for me to tell you that life is going to be easy, that happiness comes to you effortlessly. You know, I know some of you are just holding out for the hope. Even if somebody's lying to you, you just want to hear it. Okay, if that's you, this is not the channel, because I got to read the cards as they are. And I do see you've got some challenges this year. Okay. For those of you who are interested in, you know, accuracy, honesty, as much as humanly possible in a general reading, then, you know, let's get into it. I can see that for this year, Libras are dealing with some lessons on emotional mastery that hopefully are going to lead them to feel more at home. And I definitely think that home matters, family matters, childhood wounding, those kind of issues are very highlighted this year for you that you're going to be working through. And I can see, you know, that some of you are walking away from things, disconnecting from things emotionally that have left you feeling discontent. There's a lot of water energy throughout this spread, by the way. But you do have an opportunity for new love, for renewal of love, for emotional, spiritual healing. Yes, love is very much highlighted. And I can also see on the money front that some of you might be getting into a position of authority, and also needing to be very shrewd and resourceful in dealing with money, business, finance. And I could see some storylines coming up in this spread about that very issue, with maybe moving around. Definitely in the first quarter of this year, be aware of any kind of hasty, impulsive type of energy. I could see it with the astrology the first quarter of this year. And for those of you who don't know my spread, it's there's, you know, the first row is January through June, the first half of the year. And then the second row is the second half of the year, which is July through December. This first quarter of the year, January through March, some hasty, impulsive energy. And I can kind of see it over here as well in the cards where, you know, somebody might have regrets about jumping the gun on something, maybe with a breakup or a separation. I can see some of you coming into this year, this is like an old outstanding issue, and it might be a family breakup, and it's an old wound, okay? I don't think it's necessarily happening this January, but I think coming into January, there's some regret or guilt, and it has to do with some period of separation, maybe a breakup, okay, of a relationship where it was necessary, but things are going to improve, okay? And I definitely see an opportunity for get together, gathering, reconciliation. Definitely as the year progresses, I see a lot of apologies going on, but you start off with a reconciliation on the table. And it might be that right now you're apart from this person. For others of you, I could see maybe there's some monetary issues going on, but that's going to improve. Definitely, as we get further along in the months, I start seeing things turn around in March if you come into the year with financial problems, because it does seem like there's some lack or loss going on, and you're maybe very, very private about it, very secretive, trying to be very discerning about who you share this with. You have hidden knowledge that there's something that you're in need of, whether it's materially or relationally. For some of you, if you start a new relationship, if there is a reconciliation at the beginning of this year, you might decide that you're just going to keep this real private and you're not going to make it public. You're not going to announce it to anyone. This can be, a clandestine relationship. And if you are with somebody, and it is public and out in the open, it might be that you're just privately behind the scenes working on this relationship. And worst case scenario, it could be that it's almost like you're living separate lives. Okay, but there's definitely something hidden and private going on, pulling back these first 2 months of the year. And then in March, you are pull again, holding yourself back because it's in your head. You're like, I think you feel, and I saw this for really the first half of this year, a lot of this mental energy where you feel like this is what you have to do, that you have to keep these secrets or you can't talk openly about it, that this is the a discerning thing to do. And even in March, I mean, I see that somebody's holding back so that they feel like this is what I've got to do to get fairness and balance in my life and to keep stability and harmony and happiness, that they have to restrict themselves in some way. Unfortunately, I see a bit of self-imposed imprisonment and victimization here. So just be aware of that, because I'm also seeing in April that there's a stalemate and maybe a truce needs to be called, a decision needs to be made, but there's some kind of indecision where somebody's blocking their emotions, they're not opening up, they're not seeing, hearing, feeling this other person, okay? And again, I'm seeing emotional disconnect because there is a belief that this is what has to be done to maintain security, stability, and order in this relationship. And it might have to do with a father figure, by the way, or a boss, or some divine masculine energy. But by May, I could see with a messenger of fire, maybe fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And that might have been an Aries back there as well, that somebody is trying to not make a decision regarding an Aries, but with this energy, be aware of this kind of impulsive, hasty type of, it could be something really exciting coming in. I do see change. I see faded change. By the way, you have two Wheel of Fortunes coming up, and the, one over here, one over here. So throughout the year, you are having faded favor change come in, and it might come in very unexpectedly with that messenger of fire, and it is bringing in a new opportunity. And I saw that for some of you, this might be somebody who is just kind of wanting to come in and have a little moment with you, if you know what I mean. The player, right? No strings attached, something very spontaneous. And if this is being brought to you, I don't really think you're going for it, to be honest. I mean, I think you have an opportunity to get a new beginning here, but I don't know that you're going to be interested in the player type this month. You might be turning it down, or who knows, some of you, this could be your energy where you're like, you know what, I'm ready for change in my life. I'm ready to do something different. I do see here in the following month with the Devil card, which they call temptation in this deck, that you're either dealing with a Capricorn, or it could be a Cancer or a Pisces, or a Scorpio. A lot of water signs showing up for you this year, by the way. But it's like there's some kind of toxicity going on, some kind of difficulty going on that has brought a lot of disappointments. And again, hidden matters. I'm really seeing hidden emotions about maybe it's a private addiction or something, something that you feel like you can't really share with people, that it's not something that you come out in the open and talk to people about, that you are privately, it's a private battle, is what I'm hearing. It's a private battle, okay? And So there's a need for you to unblock these emotions. It might have to do with this kind of ideal husband, father figure. By the way, I saw for some of you, if you are Libra male or perhaps Libra female, dealing with a male, a water sign possibly, there could be pregnancy coming up in an expectant father coming up in May and June, by the way. Possibility of an announcement of an expectant father, okay, in May or June. But moving on to July, I see somebody's holding back, and it might be materially, relationally, emotionally, because it's almost like somebody's being very frugal. They're protecting themselves, and there's an energy, I really think related to you or another air sign, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, where there's this energy of, well, this is what I have to do. And it might be an inconvenient, uncomfortable truth about why you have to hold back. And if this is a family matter, because I got some messages that for some of you, it might be a family member involving a mother figure possibly, or how somebody goes after their gain. And it, I'm going to say, either somebody in your family is asking you for money in July, or you're asking them for money. Whoever's doing the asking is probably going to get denied. Just get ready for it, okay? Be aware that somebody's holding back. Now, in the following month, there could be a softening of this situation with the Queen of Water. Again, could be this ideal mother, wife type of person, figure, okay? A very feminine, empathic quality here. Very much emphasized, having to do with sensitivities. Very sensitive month, by the way, August, very sensitive month. Somebody might be jealous. There might need to be some sincere, open conversations, and I think there will be, about ideals and emotional values. There might be an apology that is given or gotten during this month of August. Now, moving on to September, you have the Lover's card, which could represent a Gemini, but definitely a love decision. Maybe needing to make decisions about your love life to transform some doubt that perhaps you had in previous months, transform it into trust in a relationship where you have a meeting of the minds. You can get some victory through clarity, through a breakthrough, okay, through shared values. And again, I'm seeing more about an apology, possibly involving a child or children, possibly water signs involved, like I said, maybe Gemini here with this Lover's card. But for others of you, about if this is about business and you're trying to make a decision about your career, I think the advice is that you need to make the choice that is going to give you the best return over the long term, and not go after a short-sighted gain, but look at what's going to benefit you over the long term. Getting into October with the Queen of Fire, I can see Aries, Leo, Sagittarius here yet again, and it could simply be you just stepping into your power, maybe involving an Aquarius or your ambitions, your hopes, your dreams, your spirituality, but I'm definitely seeing that there's a possibility of healing here, and the stars really aligning for you to step more into your passion. But I do want to caution you that during this month of October, there might be a person, a love interest, that is just kind of wanting a no strings attached type of relationship. They want it to be really spontaneous, almost like this. I'm getting the sense it might be a fire sign who's coming in like, oh, you know, I'm really attracted to you, but let's just live in the moment type of thing. You know, that kind of, and I don't really feel y'all are having that, because y'all are about getting order in your life. Fairness, justice, stability, security, very much about locking it down. And I see, yeah, first half of this year, very much locked down, okay, emotionally, because you're not opening up. I could see it's a recurrent theme. As you get more into August, you start opening up even more, and really, but I gotta tell you that I don't know if this person is totally on the same page with you, okay? So be aware. I don't want to discourage you, because I feel like this is a year, Libra, where you're having to learn these lessons about emotional mastery. When do you shut down and when do you open up? because I'm getting a sense here from this spread that some of you are opening up to people who don't deserve you, and you're closing yourself off to people who do. And there's some lesson here throughout this year where you're learning who to open up to, when, where, and how, and who not to, right? Moving on into November, I can see this is your energy here. By the way, Justice card showed up twice for you. Stars card showed up twice. Fortune, Wheel of Fortune twice. So really positive for you getting balance and fairness and things going in your favor this year and getting wish fulfillment and maybe having the stars align to bring you a soulmate and to bring healing. Really super positive. Okay. But you have to balance your emotional needs with the practical needs. And I think some of you are really, even by the end of the year, having trouble discerning what's viable and what's not. And that might cause you again to start pulling back. Yet, you know, go back to this pulling back that I saw earlier in the year where you open up and then you pull back again because you might have opened up to the wrong person or not quite in the right timing. It will be different for different people, but by December, I see things changing for your good, and it might be because of a fallout that at first glance, seems to be very unfortunate and causes you to kind of, again, pull back, go into a bit of a hermit mode. Might have to do with a Virgo, by the way, but really try to find your inner light and get some advice and see the truth of the matter about who you're going to take a risk and gamble on in love. Who deserves it? Who's a worthwhile risk and who's not? Because I'm seeing here all throughout this year messages on who you're going to open up to and who you're not, some key lesson. And I think that's why it ends off in a positive note, although this fallout might seem, and the pulling back might seem very negative. In the end, it's in your favor because you learn what past patterns in your relationships need to be broken so that you're opening up to the right people. And if you want more advice and oracle card advice with the angelic support showing, you know, and the divine doors that are opening up for you this year, I've got it over on Vimeo along with, you know, a lot more depth and detail in the astrology. It's for $6.99, and I've got a generous 3-month rental time frame. So conceivably, if you rent now, you can watch and rewatch for the next 3 months. And I'm doing that because I'm continuing to release more signs this month and next month. And so if you're interested in that, I hope you will join me over on Vimeo. I'll have the details down below in the link. Till next time, wishing you all the best. Be blessed.